Yes, welcome back once again to our channel Vagai Academy of Mathematics, and this is a new playlist where you can find video lessons for class 11 CBSE Applied Mathematics. So we have already successfully completed the topic calendars, and now we are stepping into a new topic, which is clocks. So here this session we are about to see the concepts and simultaneously the problems also which are related to the topic clocks, and we are going to solve all those things, entire thing here in this one single video. Yes, fine. Yeah, and before that, let's just have a view on what are all the frequently asked questions from clocks. Here are some few sample questions. Let's see them one by one. So our questions are like, yes, so at a given particular time, what is the angle between the hands of the clock? So given some particular time and you are asked to find what is the angle between the two hands of the clock. So that's a question. And yes, next is, what would be the time when the hands coincide or when the hands are opposite to each other? And the next is, what is the time when the hands meet at or they are at right angles to each other? Yes. And next, the clock gaining or losing the time. So you are going to see all the concepts and problems which are related to all these concepts. As I told, everything here in this one video itself. And for which I request you to watch this video till the end, and please do subscribe our channel also. Yes, let's begin. Let us start with the structure of a clock first of all. So now if you see a clock, no matter what shape you have your clock, you will always have the numbers in a closed round manner, a circular way, right? So in that case, if you consider one complete rotation, it will be always equal to, yes, it would be 360 degrees. Yeah, fine. So yes. And what about the hands of a clock? You will be having three hands in a clock. One is a hour hand, then a minute hand, and the seconds hand. So using these hands of what, we would be predicting what time the clock is showing. This is how we follow. And now let's have a small discussion about the speed of these hands, and particularly this hour hand and minute hand. Shall we do that? Because these concepts are what we are going to use when we solve the problems, so they are really, really important. Let's see them. So let's see about the hour hand first. So the hour hand is going to be the slowest one out of those three hands, is it or not? So when you consider a hour hand, and consider or just think about the speed of a hour hand. So how long the hour hand will take to complete one full rotation? So just think about the position of the hour hand when the time shows 12 o'clock. So when the time is showing 12 o'clock, your hover hand would exactly point the number 12. That we all know, fine. And just think of how long it would take for the hover hand to complete one rotation and come back to the same 12. So it would take how many hours? It would take exactly 12 hours. Not only for 12 o'clock, it can be any time. For example, even if you are going to consider 4 o'clock, the hover hand would exactly point the number 4, and it would take exactly one more 12 hours for the hover hand to reach back the same 4, is it or not? So in that case, for our hover hand, it would take 12 hours to complete one full rotation, or I can say it would take 12 hours to complete or just to sweep this 360 degrees, right? Let's just note it. So for the hover hand, it would take 12 hours to complete 360 degrees. Let's just reduce it. So if it is 12 hours for 360 degrees, then what would be the angle or the degree covered by the same hover hand in 1 hour? Shall we calculate it? So for 12 hours, if it is 360, then for 1 hour, we can just divide it by 12, right? So 360 by 12 would give us 30 degree. So let's have a note of it. 30 degree. Fine, yes. So that is for 1 hour, the hover hand can sweep 30 degrees, or even we can even say it as the partition between any two numbers is going to be this 30 degree. Why? Why? Because we have the entire one full rotation to be accounted to be equal to 360 degrees. In that case, if it is divided into 12 equal parts, then each partition has to be equal to this 30 degrees, and this hover hand is taking to complete that 1 hour, in that 1 hour, this hover hand is taking 30 degrees. Yes, fine. Okay. And next is, If it is 1 hour for 30 degree, then what about 1 minute for the hour hand? So for 1 minute, let's try to visualize. So we have got 60 minutes in 1 hour. So that means I can divide this 30 by 60. What is 30 by 60? So 30 by 60 would be equal to exactly half, or otherwise it can be equal to 0.5 degrees. Is it or not? So in that case, hover hand is taking 0.5 degrees. I mean, hover hand takes 1 minute to complete 0.5 degrees. So let's be clear with all the things. Let's have a revise from the beginning. Yes, hover hand can do 12 hours, it takes 360 degrees. And in 1 hour, it can cover 30 degrees. And in 1 minute, it can cover 0.5 degrees. So these things are much important. And let's now come to discuss about this minute hand. So the minute hand is the one which is going to be longer, right? Yes. So yes, consider about the minute hand. And let's start the story once again from the beginning. So say the position of the minute hand is pointing the number 12. So when it would point the number 12? So it happens every 1 hour, right? Is it or not? Say the time is, say, 8 o'clock. So what about 8 o'clock? So the hover hand would be pointing the number 8, whereas the minute hand would point the number 12, exactly 12, right? And what do you think about this minute hand? Or how long it would take for the minute hand to complete one full rotation and come reach the same number 12? How long it would take? So for the minute hand, if you just think and see, it would take just 1 hour to complete one full rotation. Is it or not? So that means the speed of the minute hand is going to be in 1 hour. I mean, to complete the same 360 degrees, minute hand would take just 1 hour. Fine, yes. And yeah, now let's again calculate for what happens in 1 minute. Is that okay? So if it is 1 hour for 360 degrees, then in 1 minute, how long it would take? I mean, how much degrees it can sweep? So we have got 60 minutes in 1 hour. So in that case, I can divide this 360 by 60, right? So 360 by 60 would give you exactly 6 degrees. So be clear, it would take just 1 minute for minute hand to cover this 6 degrees, or for every 1 minute, this minute hand can cover 6 degrees in the clock. Yes, fine. And in general, we will always be worrying about only these two hands. I mean, the hover hand and minute hand. It won't affect our, we don't generally discuss about the second hand. So it is important for us to know the concept or the all the things which are behind these two hands. That alone is enough for us to solve the problems. Yes, fine. And now the next important point is, what about the angle between the two hands? That's the next important thing we are going to discuss. Yes, let's do that. Just suppose you have the clock here. Now, if you see this clock, what time it is showing? It is showing the time 7:20. Is it or not? Now, what if I ask you a question, that what is the angle between this hover hand and minute hand of this clock? So how can we get the answer for this question? Now, there are two approaches by which we can get the answer for this angle. One is by the practical approach. That is, we can just see the partitions and then add it up to get the answer. That is one way. But this kind of approach won't be helpful, or it won't be comfortable always. So just think of another method. What if we have a formula, so that if we have that formula, we can substitute the numbers there and directly we get the answer. That is by the theoretical way. Now let us try to get a formula with which we can easily find the angle between the two hands, what the time is showing between the clocks, between the two hands of the clock. Okay, so let's try for that. So consider the time is some h hours and m minutes. That can be any time. It can be like 7 hours and 20 minutes, or it can be like 6:10 in the sense our hours will be 6 and minutes will be 10, like that. Okay, so we have h hours and m minutes, and let us now try to derive a formula with which we can easily find the angle between the two hands of the clock. Okay, yes, fine. So let us have that angle. We will notate it to be some theta. And now what we will do is, we'll just do this construction in such a way that we will first try to find the angle swept by the hover hand from this 12. I mean, from this position 12, how long this hover hand has moved, that we will calculate. And the same way, we will also calculate how much angle this minute hand also is sweeping. Okay, it is sweeping how much angle. Now let us take both those values, and if we take the difference of those two angles itself, we can very easily get the value of this theta. Is it or not? Is this approach clear? Now this is what we are going to do now. And for which, what method can we handle? Yes, first come up with this hover hand. Okay, now take this hover hand. Here for h hovers we need to calculate the angle turned by this hover hand. Now we clearly know that this hover hand in 1 hour it can complete or it can sweep 30 degrees. So in that case, for h hours, how much angle it can sweep? It can sweep an angle of 30 h. Fine. Yes. Now let's come to the minute hand also. Let's come to the minute hand, and minute hand is going to cross m minutes. And come to the minute hand. Minute hand in 1 minute it can turn for 6 degrees. And for m minutes, how many degrees can it sweep? Very simple, right? So for m minutes, that minute hand can sweep for 6 m minutes. So be clear with the steps. Hover hand in h hours 30 h degrees, and minute hand in m minutes 6 m degrees. So far it is clear, right? Then next, what we have to do is we should also consider one more thing here. The thing is, by the time that minute hand is going to arrive, or it is going to complete few minutes here, and that same time interval, this hover hand would have also swept a few degree more. Is the point clear? Right? Like when it is, the time is 7 o'clock, our hover hand will be exactly pointing this 7. But now if you see this clock, this time shows 7:20. So in the 20 minutes gap, definitely this hover hand would have swept some more angle. So how much angle it would have swept? So for which, we'll come to the hover hand in minutes time. Okay, so in 1 minute, hover hand is moving for 0.5 degrees. Then for m minutes, how much it would move, how much degrees it would have moved, that we have to think. Okay, so for the hover hand, I mean in the perspective view of hover hand, in 1 minute it can move 0.5, it can cover 0.5 degrees. So for m minutes it can cover 0.5 m degrees, right? So this difference will always exist, right? So in that case, minute hand is covering a 6 m degrees, and hover hand is covering 0.5 m degrees in the same m minutes. So there would be an apparent change of, let's take a difference, the difference would be exactly 5.5 m. fine. So that means the overall angle in terms of minutes, it would be 5.5 m. Now our theta can be obtained when we take the difference between these two values itself. Fine. Is it clear? So our theta will be nothing but the difference between 30 h and 5.5 m. so given h hours and m minutes, if you come to ask, or if you need to know what is the angle between your hover hand and minute hand, just take the h value and m value, substitute here in the formula, and get these two values first and take their difference, and that will give you the answer. And here the important point is, this difference can be of any order. I mean, it can either be 30 h minus 5.5 m, or otherwise this theta can even be sometimes 5.5 m minus 30 h. both are possible. Why, you may have this doubt. I will explain it once again. Okay, why? Because this theta is 30 h minus 5.5 m in one case. This is possible, I mean this first case is possible, when your hover hand is ahead of your minute hand. Just think of your hand's position in your clock. Let's take this 7:20 itself as an example. Okay, so when the time shows 7:20, what happens is your hover hand, I mean this small hand, is ahead of your minute hand. See, this is pointing only at 4, whereas this hover hand has already crossed that 7. Yes, I mean this 4. So in that case, this is in front and this is at back. Now my minute hand is behind this hover hand. That's the reason we have to use this formula. At which positions, I mean like at which situations? At situations when your hover hand is far away, I mean it is away from your minute hand, I mean it is ahead of your minute hand, we have to use this formula. But if it is in the other case, when your minute hand is ahead of your hover hand, for example, if the time shows 2:20, let's take 2:20. Okay, In the case of 220, what happens is your hover hand will be only here, somewhere between 2 and 3. But your minute hand would have crossed your hover hand's position. Is the point clear? In those situations, this value would be more than compared to this value. So in that case, our order of getting the difference will be like 5.5m minus 30h. So that's the reason we have two different formulas. But anyways, it will not affect your answer that you're going to get. Just take the difference, okay? In any order, it is not going to affect your answer. In any order you can take, just take your positive answer alone, okay? Just to know the concept behind that, I'm just giving this explanation. So this is possible when your hover hand is ahead of minute hand, and this formula is possible when your minute hand is ahead of your hover hand. That's the only difference. But apart from that, you can use any formula, okay? You can just take these two values, take the difference and record that positive difference to be your final answer. That's it, okay? So in general, we can even take this, give this formula as theta is equal to 30h minus 5.5m, the whole modulus. So where that modulus represent the absolute value. I mean, it will give the non-negative value to be your answer. That's it, okay? So now this formula you can use to get the angle between the two hands for a given time. That's it. So it's now the time for us to work the questions. So here we have a set of questions. Let's try them one by one. Okay, yes. Find the angle between the hover hand and minute hand when the time shows these following questions. So take the first one, 5:10. So the time is 5:10 now. Let's clearly try to fix the positions of the two hands here. Okay, so when the time is showing 5:10, where will be our hover hand and where will be the minute hand? Let's try to visualize that. So our hover hand will be nearer to 5. Is it or not? Because the time is showing 5:10. In that case, it will be somewhere near that 5. It would have just crossed that 5. And what about our minute hand? Our minute hand is at, I mean, the minutes is showing 10. In that case, our minute hand would be at the position 2. I mean, the number 2, right? So now if you see these positions itself, it is very clear that our hover hand is ahead of our minute hand. I mean, our hover hand will be pointing the 5, but the minute hand will be at 2 only, right? So in that case, it is better if we use the first formula itself, okay? So first one, the time is 5:10, is it or not? So let's try to use the formula. Theta is equal to 30h minus 5.5m. So we'll use this formula. So 30h in the sense 30 times of 5, because h represents that hours, 5 here, and m for that minutes, which is 10 here. Shall we try this? So it would give us 30 times of 5 would be 150, and as minus 5.5 times of 10 would be 55. So which is nothing but 95, correct? So the answer is 95 degrees. That's it. That's going to be the answer. Okay. Yes. Fine. So coming to the second question. So here our time is 4:30, and let's again do the same thing here. We'll try to visualize the positions of the two hands. So at 4:30, our hover hand will be pointing towards 4. I mean, it will be midway between 4 and 5. That is okay. But it would have crossed 4. We'll take it like that. Okay. And yes, 30. What about this 30? 30 in the sense? It means the minutes is 30. So in that case, our minute hand would be pointing 6, exactly 6. Fine. So see here, this case, our minute hand is ahead of our hover hand. Am I right? Because our minute hand will be pointing towards 6, whereas the hover hand would be at between 4 and 5 only. So in that case, here we should be using the reverse formula, right? I mean the other way of using the formula. So theta is going to be now 5.5 times of m minus 30 times of h. I hope you're able to catch the point here. So 5.5 times of 30 minus 30 times of 4. So this would be our answer. So I think it would give us 5.5 times of 30 would be 165, and minus 30 times of 4 would be just 120, right? So that means our answer would be equal to 45 degree, and that's the answer. Or another way how we can do this is, we have 30 in both the places, so we can factor out this 30, and inside we would have 5.5 minus 4, which would be 1.5. So 30 times 1.5 would be still 45 degrees only. So however, answer is 45 degree for our second question. And coming to our third question, question number 3 here. So again, the same kind of analysis. Our time is 11:15 here. Note it here, 11:15. And here hour hand will be near 11, right? And minute hand, what about minute hand? Minute hand will be at, I mean, the minutes is showing 15. Minute hand will be exactly at 3, right?
Yes,
I'm noting it here. So again, this is like our first situation only, right? So our hour hand is ahead of our minute hand. In that case, again, once again, we should go back to our first formula only. So theta is equal to, I hope you are able to see what I'm writing here. So theta is equal to 30 times of 11 minus 5.5 times of 15, right?
Yes.
So in that case, it would be 30 times of 11 is 330 minus 5.5 times of 15. So this is quite challenging, right? So how can we multiply this 5.5 times 15? Let's do a very simple thing. Just multiply 55 into 15. So this would give us the answer. Shall we try this? So 5 5s are 25, 2s are carry. 5 5 is 25, 5 1s are 1. 5 1s are 5. So 25 and 1 will make 5 will make 30. 30 plus 2 is 32. So carry over is 3. I'm just using the cross straight away multiplication. Okay. And 5 1s are 5. 5 plus 3 would be 8. So it would be 825. And in that case, if it is 5.5, our answer would be 1 decimal point before. So it would be 82.5 if I'm right. Correct. So 330 minus 82.5. What would be our answer? So this is what we have to calculate. And if we do so, we would be getting our answer to be equal to, this is 300 minus 80 would be 220, and here 27.5. So 220 and 27.5. So 220 and 27.5 would be 247.5. You can check the answer. So our angle degrees is 247.5 degrees is going to be the answer. But here one point we should be keeping in our mind, we should be very careful here. See the angle in what way we are getting. Sometimes if you come to attend a multiple choice question, or if they are very much specific in the question, you may find that this answer is going to be, what you have obtained here is going to be a wrong answer. I will tell the reason why it is. Because see here, this answer what we are getting is 247.5 degrees, and this is giving you the larger angle. Okay, so I will make you understand it by showing the positions of the two hands. So when it is 11:15, right? Okay, so your clock is like this. Maybe just roughly I'm drawing and showing you. 11 is here and 3 is here. So when the time is showing 11:15, your hour hand will be somewhere here, I mean between 11 and 12, and your minute hand will be exactly at 3. This is how your positions will be. And in that case, you are getting this answer to be 247.5, and this is nothing but the angle that you can see here, that you are seeing here. This angle is what is 247.5, and this is the larger angle. If in case you want the smaller angle, I mean the shorter side angle, you need to calculate this remaining portion. And how can that be got? It's so easy, right? So if you want the shorter angle, okay, the shorter or the smaller angle, so it's nothing but you can just take 360 and subtract it. That's it. Okay, because you know that the full angle is 360 degrees. So 360 minus 247.5 would give you the answer. And now your shorter side angle would be equal to, so I think this would be 160 minus 47 would be 13. And in that case, 12.5. So 12.5, is it or not? So 112.5. I mean, this angle, the shorter angle is going to be 112.5 degrees is going to be the answer for this question, if in case you need the shorter angle. Okay, because in the other two cases we got the shorter angle itself, but here in this case we are getting the larger angle. In that case, there's nothing to worry about it. You can take the shorter angle just by subtracting it. Okay, and if you see your answer is more than 180, okay, this is a clue. This is how you can keep it in your mind. If your answer what you are getting here is more than 180, that means it corresponds to the larger angle. And what if you need to find the smaller angle? You just need to subtract that answer from 360, you get the answer, and that's how you finish the problem. Okay, now let us move on to the next variety of questions. So here our questions are, at what time between 5 and 6 the hands of the clock coincide with each other? So this is our question. So this is about the hands, I mean the minute hand and hour hand, they both are going to coincide with each other. Just think of at which moments in the clock this kind of event would happen. So you can just see both the hands are at the same position. That is what we call it as coinciding. Okay, So very easily we can see this event happening at exactly 12 o'clock. Is it or not? Because at the time 12 o'clock, when you just look at the clock, you will find both the hands are exactly pointing at 12. So after 12 o'clock, can you imagine this event would again happen when? So you will even observe this event happening after 1 o'clock. I mean, just after some 1 o'clock. If you are very much keen, you can notice that this would happen somewhere between 1:05 and 1:10. Same way, again, the next time you can see this one happening from 2:10 to 2:15. Then next 3:15 to 3:20 and so on. So if you look at this, this coinciding win event, it will happen for exactly 11 times for every 12 hours. This is the concept, okay? So now let's come to the theoretical way to solve this kind of problems. So when the hands are going to coincide, what we shall do? It's going to be very, very simple. Just think of what would be the value of our theta. That will get the answer to the problem very easily, right? So when it's going to coincide, it is like two rays, two lines, and they're going to coincide. What would be the angle between the two lines? So here the lines are nothing but are two hands of the clock. So the theta would be none other than 0 degree. Is it or not? So we can easily work this problem by taking theta to be equal to 0 degrees. Fine? Yes? Yeah, okay. So now coming back to the problem, at what time between 5 and 6? This is what they're asking. So that means now we are sure with hour's value. Okay, so h is equal to 5, this we are sure. But the thing is, what minutes it is? That minutes value we should be finding now. How can you find it? Very easy. We know the value of h and we know theta is 0 degrees. Now we can very well use the formula to get the answer. Shall we do that? Yeah. So let's use the formula. 30h minus 5.5m. The value is going to be nothing but 0 degrees. Is it or not? Yeah. Okay. So 30 times of 5 minus 5.5 times of m is equal to 0. And here at this point, the usage of formula, I mean like whether this minus this or this minus this, that doesn't affect the problem. Why? Because since the hands are going to coincide, it will not affect which formula we are going to use. We would anyways get the answer very easily. Fine. So yes, continue. So I think we will get 5.5m is equal to 150. So that means m will be equal to 150 divided by 5.5. That is how we will be getting. So now what I will do is I will multiply both the numerator and denominator by 2. So that what will happen is this 150 by 5.5 would become 300 by 11. I hope you are able to understand this, right? Because in order to avoid the decimals, I'm doing like this. So I would get m is equal to 150 by 5.5. The same thing, I'm just doubling both numerator and denominator so that we would be ending up with 300 by 11. So now we will write this fraction in terms of mixed fraction. We'll try to write as mixed fraction. So 11 in 300, we can go up to, I think 20. Okay, we'll go step by step. So 11 twos are 22. So that means we will have 8 to be our remainder. So we have 80 here. So 11 and 80, we have 11, 7s are 77, and balance we have 3. So that means 3 by 11. So that means our minutes value is going to be 27, 3 by 11. So we are getting it in mixed fraction. This is the way we will be getting, since we are getting this question with coinciding concept. So after how many minutes? After 5, we will be getting the hands coinciding is, this is after 27, 3 by 11 minutes. Is what this coinciding event will happen. Okay, so that means our answer is 5/27, 3 by 11. This is going to be our answer, or otherwise we can even answer it as after 27, 3 by 11 minutes, this event would happen. That's it, very simple. Okay, yeah, fine. And the next part is, we'll go to the next question. Let's see what is there here. At what time between 8 and 9, the hands of the clock are opposite to each other? So this time we are getting the concept of opposite to each other. So it's exact opposite of this situation. I mean the first one situation. Okay. So here these two hands are opposite to each other. That means the position of the two hands, if you just continue, you should be able to draw a straight line in such a way your two hands are positioned. Just think of when this event will happen. You can just imagine, and very easily you can say that, for instance, at 6 o'clock, this event would happen. Is it or not? Can you just imagine the clock now? 6 o'clock. It is exactly 6 o'clock. You can visualize, you can see the hands, two hands, I mean the hour hand and minute hand, they both will be exactly opposite to each other. So this is what happens. And after 6, when this would happen is when 7:05 to 7:10, once again this event would happen. And same way, if you continue and so on, if you go, this also you can observe that this event would again happen for 11 times for every 12 hours. This point you have to remember. All right? Yes. So that means opposite. Now again, coming to discuss about theta, just think of what would be the theta's value when you have your hands opposite to each other. It's going to be very simple. Theta will be now 180 degrees. Is it or not? So now we have to take our theta's value to be equal to 180 and solve the problem. That's it. Okay. So let me draw a line because it may confuse it. So for opposite, theta is equal to 180 degrees. And now we will concentrate on the second problem. So at what time between 8 and 9 here they're asking. So that means for this problem, our hour's value is going to be 8. And again, we are focused to find the value of minutes. I mean M. M value is what we need to find. So yes, we can use the formula. So, but this time we should be very careful about using the formula. See here, we can either use 30H minus 5.5M or the other way, 5.5M minus 30H. Let's try to position see the positions of the two hands of the clock when this event is going to happen. Okay, all right. Yeah, I'll just draw a rough clock now. And between 8 and 9, that means our hour hand will be somewhere between 8 and 9. Is it or not? Because it will be somewhere here. And what about our minute hand? Minute hand will be exactly on the opposite side. See, this is the position of hour hand. It is somewhere between 8 and 9. And that's the reason I'm drawing like this. And just think about your minutes hand. Minutes hand will be where? It will be somewhere pointing towards this side. Right? So it will be here. Right? So here, this one, if you see this position of these two hands, it is very, very clear that your hour hand is ahead of your minute hand, because at this position, maybe your minute hand will be somewhere between 1, 2 or 3 in that area only, in that portion only. In that case, definitely your hour hand is ahead of your minute hand. So in this case, we are supposed to use the first formula only. I mean 30H minus 5.5M. So let's use 30H minus 5.5M is equal to 180, and that will solve and get the answer. Fine. Yes. So 30 times of H, our H value is 8, minus 5.5M will be equal to 180 degree. We'll hold on this. And now let's continue. So 30 times of 8 would be actually 240. So 240 minus 5.5M is equal to 180. And continuing this, we would get 5.5M is equal to 240 minus 180, that would be 60. So let's record it. And finally, M would be equal to 60 divided by 5.5. Is it or not? And let's do the same thing. In order to avoid the decimals, I'm going to double both numerator and denominator. So 60 by 5.5 would now become 120 by 11. I hope you're able to understand, get this point. So M is equal to 120 by 11. Once again, turning this as a mixed fraction, we would get 120 in 11. We can go up to 11 tenths or 110, right? Because 11 11 star would be 121. So we can't go there. So 11 tenths are 110 and remainder would be exactly 10, because we have 120 here. So 10 as a remainder, we have 11 in the denominator. So 10, 10 by 11 is going to be the answer. So between 8 and 9, at what time this event exactly happens is, it happens when the time shows 8, 10, 10 by 11. This is going to be the answer. Or otherwise, we can even tell it as after 10 minutes, 10 by 11 minutes, after 8, past 8, this opposite, the hands are opposite to each other, this event would happen. This is going to be the answer for the second question. The next question variety is about right angles. So we'll see the question. At what time between 6 and 7, the hands of the clock are at right angles? So we simply know the meaning of what is right angles. Right angle simply means 90 degrees, is it or not? So yes, now we are supposed to find between 6 and 7, at what time your hands will be at right angles. The angle between the hour hand and minute hand should be equal to 90 degrees. That will happen when? This is what our question is. Now, if we just deeply think about it, we can understand one thing here. So this occasion, this one will happen not just in one moment, not just in one situation. So between 6 and 7, this would happen for two times. Just think of it. Why? Because between 6 and 7, our hover hand's position will be somewhere like this. Is it or not? Right? because between 6 and 6, our numbers 6 and 7 will be like this, here and here, and our hover hands position will be between the 6 and 7 only. And think about the position of the minute hand. So to maintain an angle of 90 degree, we have two possibilities here. Either our minute hand can be here, because now also we can maintain a 90 degree angle, or otherwise our minute hand's position can even be like this, somewhere here. Now here also we can have 90 degree. So this is the reason we have two possibilities in order to get this 90 degree. And this is not only for 6 to 7. You can see for all the times, 1 to 2 or 2 to 3 or 3 to 4 or 7 to 8, whatever it is, this 90 degree occasion will happen twice. Two times it will happen. So how can we get the answers? Both the answers. How can we do that? It's going to be again very simple, because closely watch these two situations. In one of them, hover hand is ahead of the minute hand, whereas in the other, our minute hand is ahead of the hover hand. That's it, right? So what we can do? Just use both the formulas, right? Okay. So let's use both the formulas. I will do one at a time. I will do one side, I will do one calculation. The other one I will do on the other side, okay? So we will take both the formulas. Theta is equal to one side, we will have 30H minus 5.5M is equal to our theta value. And the other side, we will have the other formula. 5.5M minus 30H is equal to theta. We will plan like this. And now we will develop both these things and we will get both the answers, both possible answers we would be able to get now itself. Okay, let's see how it is going to work. And we are now clear with the value of H here, because H value is between 6 and 7. In that case, we must take the value of H to be equal to 6. That's it. So in that case, H, if I take it to be the value of 6 here, in the first case, we will get 30 times of 6 minus 5.5m is equal to theta, right angle, obviously it is 90 degree. So I'll put it 90 here. And next we have 180 minus 5.5m is equal to 90 degree. So that we would get 5.5m is equal to, so here we would get 180 minus 90, which would be 90 degree here. So first case we are getting 5.5m is equal to 90 degree. So that means our m value will be equal to 180 by 11. I hope you are able to understand how it is coming. So I am just taking 90 by 5.5, that I am developing and doing it as, writing it as 180 by 11. That's it. So yes, express this as a mixed fraction. We would be getting one time it would be 11, balance is 80, seven time it is 77, so balance is 3. So 17, 3 by 11. Let me check it whether I am right. So it would be like, once again I will check it. So yes, it is like 11 ones are 11. I'm putting it one here. So I'm very, very sorry. It is going to be 7. The remainder is going to be 7. It is not 8. It is going to be 7. So I have missed it. So sorry. We'll have a change in the answer. So it is going to be 70 now. And so now our answer will be 6 times. Yes, because 11 6 are, it is 66. So in that case, we will have the remainder to be only 4. So 16, 4 by 11 is going to be one possible answer. I hope you are able to understand this. I made a small mistake there in the calculation. So 180 by 11, this would be this. And let me recheck this. 11 into 16 will be 176 plus 4 will be 180. Yes, answer verified. Now I can be very sure. So one possible answer is 16, 4 by 11. This is one possible answer. And that is when? That is for this first case. Do you understand? Because see here, 16, 4 by 11, it is more or less equal to the 16, 4 by 11. So after 6 past, 6 past 16, 4 by 11 minutes, we will have this 90 degree happening once. And what about the next occasion? What's the second case? For which we have to develop the second side. Shall I do this? So if I continue, so here I would get 5.5m minus 30H. Now comes 30H. So 30 times of H is again 6 only, is equal to 90 degree. So here I would get 5.5m. I think I can do it directly. So 5.5m is equal to here. Anyways, I would get 30 times of 6 to be 180. 180 plus 90 would be 270 degrees. And now m value will be 270 by 5.5, which is none other than 540 by 11. Again, I'm doubling both numerator and denominators. So yes, continuing this, m is equal to, I think go for, I will go conventionally itself, okay? because I may commit a mistake here, that's why. So 11 and I have 54, so we can go up to 4 times, is it or not? Because 11 4s are 44, only till 4 times we can go. So balance I have 10, that means I have 100 here. So 11 in 100 we can go up to 11 9s are 99 and exactly 1 is our balance. So 49, 1 by 11, and that's going to be the other possible answer. And for this occasion, I mean, your minute hand is ahead of your hour hand. So that is when your minute hand shows 49, 1 by 11. Okay, yes, anyways, I'll just recheck it and see. So 49 times of 11 would be equal to 490, and 49, it will be 539 plus 1 is 540. Yes, done, success. So yes, so now we are getting both possible answers. So between 6 and 7 at right angles, one occasion 16, 4 by 11 minutes it would happen. I mean, we will have a right angle, and the other occasion is 49, 1 by 11 minutes. The other time it would happen, I mean the right angle would happen. So these are going to be the answers for this particular question. And the next interesting part we are going to see here is about gaining and losing concept. Okay, so a clock is going to gain some minutes or gain some seconds or lose minutes, lose seconds. This kind of questions are what we are going to see here. Now instead of focusing on the concept, it would be very much interesting if we directly get into the problem itself. Let's just go see the problem and try to understand what the concept is. Yes, fine. Yeah, okay. So our first question is, a clock gains 3 minutes for every 1 hour. So what do you mean by that? Clock gains 3 minutes for every 1 hour. So let's try to understand the meaning of this first part. So this first question is about gaining's concept. Okay, clock gains, importantly, this is very much important, 3 minutes for every 1 hour. What is the meaning of that? And yes, still we continue this. If it is set right at 6 a.m. and what time will it show at 9 p.m. this same day? And this is our question. So yes, so we'll take the first part of the question. If it is set right at 6 a.m. so it is some day and the clock is set right at 6 a.m. okay, so yes, so we will also note it. So the clock is now showing the time 6 a.m. and this is the correct time. Yes, fine. And this particular clock is doing what? It is going to gain 3 minutes for every 1 hour. That point is very much important. So let's say this is going to be the correct clock, okay, which is going to show the time 6 a.m. and this one, this is going to be our clock, I mean our gaining clock. So for identity, I will just name it. This is going to be the gaining clock and this one is going to be the correct clock. Let's see what happens and let's try to compare and read what happens or what difference is going to be undergone here in both these timings. Okay, yes. And now let's try to understand the first sentence of this question. Clock gains 3 minutes for every 1 hour. What is the meaning of the 3 minutes for every 1 hour? That means if I consider this correct clock, what time will it be after 1 hour? This is morning 6 a.m. Okay, I will also write this a.m. here. Fine, done. And what will be the time after one hour here? After 1 hour, we know that it is very simple. This clock, I mean a correct clock, will show the time to be 7 a.m. Is it or not? But what happens to this gaining clock is, this is what we have to understand. This clock is going to gain 3 minutes for every 1 hour. So the thing is, this will be showing 3 minutes after. I mean, like, this is going to gain. I mean, here you will have this clock taking a time of extra 3 minutes. So that means this clock at the same time, when this correct clock is going to show the time of 7, here this gaining clock would show a time of 7:03 a.m. I hope now you're able to understand. Is the point clear? This is the concept of gaining. Okay, all right. And what happens after one more hour? You can now visualize. So after one more hour, so this clock will show the time 8 a.m. but what about here, this case? So again after 1 hour, this will again gain one more 3 minutes and showing a time of 8:06. So this was what happens for this second gaining clock. I mean, for every 1 hour, 1 hour, it would take extra three minutes and go. So this is what happens and this goes on. And what is our question now? Our question is, then at what time will it show at 9 p.m. the same day? This is our question. The question is very simple for us to understand. So if this trend is going to continue, what happens that same day night? I mean, this is 9 p.m. it is given, it is not 9 a.m. okay, so if it is 9 a.m. now, it is going to be next 1 hour. Okay, even I can even show you what happens after next 1 hour. This will be 9 a.m. Whereas what would be the time? I think you yourself can easily tell this. What will be the time shown here? It would be simply 9 a.m. Very simple, right? Yes. So this is what happens. But our question is, what will be the time shown when this one shows 9 p.m.? What will be the time shown here? This is the question. I hope this question is clear to you. Okay. Now the time is 9 p.m. in the correct clock. At the same time, what time will be shown here? That is our question. So how can this be answered? Just think it. Okay. One way is you can just continue the same way and go reach your time till you reach 9 p.m. But it's going to be a very lengthy method, right? What smart way you can do here? It's very, very simple, right? We very well know that for every 1 hour, you are going to get extra 3 minutes. Then just directly go for a direct jump. Now see, from 6 a.m. to 9 p.m., just think of how many hours you have crossed. Just imagine 6 a.m. to 9 p.m. I mean the same day, how many hours we would have crossed. Just think about it. It's very simple for us to calculate, right? It's so easy. See here, 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. the same day, it would be exactly 12 hours. Because morning 6 to evening 6, it's going to be 12 hours. And 6 p.m. to 9 p.m., extra 3 hours. So that means you have a jump of 15 hours. Correct? That's what happens. Now, here also you would have 15 hours. But for every 1 hour, you are gaining 3 minutes. And in that case, for 15 hours, how many minutes you would have gained in total? That we have to think of. So if you think like that, you would be getting 15 threes are 45. Am I right? So let's do it. 15 threes are 45 minutes you would have gained. I mean, this clock would have gained. Then it is very, very easy for us to get the answer as, now this clock will show a time of 9, but it is extra 45 minutes. So 45 p.m. So the answer for the first question is going to be 9:45 p.m. That's going to be the answer. Quite interesting, right? Yes, fine. Yeah. So now I hope you are able to get the logic of the gaining concept. Okay, what concept is running behind this? Now the same thing is applicable for a losing clock also. So here if you see, the next question is based on clock loses. And next, we will see what is given here in the next question. Let's see here what is given here. So a clock loses 30 seconds for every 1 hour. So here we should be very careful here. So this clock is going to lose time in terms of seconds. Right? Okay. So in that case, if it is going to be seconds, it is going to be even more meticulous. That we have to understand. Okay. So this is 3 minutes. So 1 hour, 3 minutes, 1 hour, 3 minutes. It would be comparatively easy to calculate. But this one for 1 hour, it's just 30 seconds losing. So in that case, for an example, like here we had an example, right? So for the same way, here also we will take an example. Okay. For instance, why not we take the same time? Okay. We will have a correct clock. And we would have a losing clock. So let's try the second question now. This question I'm just going to try here now. And I'm going to take the same time. Okay. This time I'm going to take 6 a.m. I mean a correct clock is going to take 6 a.m. And precisely here I'm going to write the timing in terms of hours, minutes and seconds. I hope why you're able to catch the reason. Because our losing thing is given in terms of seconds here for this question. That's the reason. Okay, it's going to lose 30 seconds for every 1 hour. That's the flow it is given here. So here 6 a.m. and our losing clock is also showing 6 a.m. Say both the clocks are set right at morning 6 a.m. And let's see the magic what happens after 1 hour. After 1 hour, a correct clock will show the time as 7 a.m. No doubt in that. It's going to show 7 a.m. Whereas, what about the losing clock? What time it will show? By this time you would have guessed what time it would have shown. So yes, this will be showing a time which is 30 seconds, exactly 30 seconds less than the correct time. Yes. Okay. That means 30 seconds less than this 7 o'clock. That is the time this clock would show. So if I want to be exact, that time would be nothing but 6 hours, 59 minutes and 30 seconds. So I hope you are able to catch this. So this is nothing but just 30 seconds lesser than 7 a.m. That's what I've recorded here. Fine. Yes. So this way only this losing clock will go. That is the way this clock is designed. Anyways, we'll just continue the question. What is asked? How many days? Okay. Let's be careful with the words they are using. How many days will it take for this clock? This clock to differ by exactly 1 hour from a correct running clock. Is the question clear? Are you able to understand this? So if the same trend is going to continue, then how long it will take for this losing clock to differ by exactly 1 hour? I mean, if I make them run the same way, then after how much time, or to be precise, after how many days it is asking. They are very much clear about it. After how many days, if this trend is going to continue, after how many days, I will have a difference of 1 hour between these two clocks. That is the equation. Okay, so the difference between this correct clock and this losing clock itself should be equal to 1 hour. That is the equation. Yes, fine. So how can we calculate this? This, if you still think one step ahead, you would be very easily get the answer. You'll be very easily able to get the answer. So let's think about it. So I know that for every 1 hour, there will be 30 seconds loss. For 1 hour, I will have 30 seconds loss. And if there should be a difference between 1 hour between these two clocks, then what is the meaning? Then it means there should be a loss of 1 hour. That's the thing. And try to write that 1 hour in terms of seconds. How many seconds you will get? So that means this one will be definitely ahead and this one will be slow. Maybe this clock will show some 8 a.m. and this would show 7 a.m. Whatever it is, we are not sure about it exactly. Or if this may show 11 a.m., this will show 10 a.m. That is what happens, right? Because if there is a difference of 1 hour, definitely this would be ahead than this. Because since this is a losing clock, this would be ahead of, this one will be ahead of this. So in that case, there will be a 1 hour difference. Try to write that 1 hour in terms of seconds. So just try to write it. 1 hour will be equal to how many seconds? So 1 hour each 1 hour, we will have 60 minutes and each minute will have 60 seconds. So 60 times 60 will be 3600 seconds. So that means we should have a difference of 3600 seconds between these two clocks. Is the point clear? Yes, fine. So I know that in 1 hour, there is a 30 seconds loss. It takes 1 hour to lose 30 seconds. Then it would take how many hours to lose 3600 seconds? If you think that way, you are getting the answer. Very simple. Okay. So let me just repeat it, or let me just try to write it maybe here. Okay. Yes, fine. So for exactly 1 hour, you will have a 30 seconds loss. So for 30 seconds loss, it is 1 hour. Then for 3600 seconds, it will take how many hours? We will just think about it. Then we can get the answer. So first we will get the answer in terms of hours first. Okay. So 3600 and 1 hour. Okay. It is very simple for us to think. We can just divide 3600 by 30. So it would give us 0 and 0 cancel, and 360 by 3, it would be giving 120 hours. So answer is 120 hours. So that means it will take 120 hours to, I mean, we have to wait for 120 hours to have a 1 hour difference. But our question is in terms of days, how many days it is. So in that case, our answer has to be in terms of days. Just try to express this 120 hours in terms of days. We will have 120 by 1 day, you have 24 hours. So 120 by 24 will give you 5 days. I hope you are able to get the answer the way we are approaching it. Okay, yes. So this losing concept, this way we are trying and getting the answer. I hope you are able to understand the steps, how we are making it. So first of all, we just consider the losing time. It is going to be 30 seconds, and overall we need a 3600 seconds difference, and that will take for 120 hours. And 120 hours, again, in terms of days we are calculating. Since they are insisting us to get the answer in terms of days, we are turning it to be days, and the answer is 5 days, and that's going to be the final answer for this question. So yes, I hope you are able to understand all the things, you are understood all the things that we have seen in today's session about the clocks, how to calculate the degrees, angle, and the different cases about opposite to each other, coincide, right angles, and finally gaining and losing concept. Everything you are able to understand. And if you find that this session was useful, please give a like here. And also, if you feel that this session would benefit any of your friends, please do share this video to your friends also. Let them also get benefited. And as requested, please do subscribe our channel. And yes, if time permits in the future, we can even work out some other miscellaneous question from this clocks chapter. Yes, fine. Yes. Yeah, fine. And yeah, of course, as early as possible, let's catch up in the next session. See you soon there. Thank you so much.